A formal rule for dividing fractions requires rewriting the division problem as a multiplication problem using the reciprocal of the divisor. Dividing by a fraction is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. Before we look at several examples, let's review the definition of reciprocal. A pair of numbers are reciprocals if their product is 1. For example, the reciprocal of 2/3 is 3/2 because their product is 1. And let's go ahead and verify this. 2/3 times 3/2 is equal to 6/6, which does equal 1. Notice how if we're given the fraction 2/3, to form the reciprocal, we interchange the numerator and denominator, which gives us 3/2. We say 2/3 is a reciprocal of 3/2, and 3/2 is reciprocal of 2/3. Going back to our examples, our first quotient is 1 divided by 1/2, and we're asked to write this as an equivalent multiplication problem. Well, dividing by 1/2 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. Because reciprocal of 1/2 is 2 over 1, 1 divided by 1/2 is equivalent to 1 times 2 over 1. And because 1 is not a fraction, we can simplify 2 over 1 to 2 and just write this as 1 times 2, which equals 2. So because this product is equal to 2, 1 divided by 1/2 is also equal to 2. And 2 is the simplified quotient. Next we have 2/3 divided by 1/9. Dividing by 1/9 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. The reciprocal of 1/9 is 9 over 1, and therefore 2/3 divided by 1/9 is equivalent to 2/3 times 9 over 1. Multiplying, we get 18/3, which simplifies perfectly to 6 because 18 divided by 3 is equal to 6. So because this product is equal to 6, so is the quotient. 2/3 divided by 1/9 is equal to 18/3, which equals 6. And 6 is the simplified quotient. Next we have 1/9 divided by 1/3. Dividing by 1/3 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. The reciprocal of 1/3 is 3 over 1. So 1/9 divided by 1/3 is equivalent to 1/9 times 3 over 1, which is equal to 3/9, which simplifies to 1/3. Notice 3 and 9 share a common factor of 3. 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3. So because this product is equal to 1/3, so is the original quotient. 1/9 divided by 1/3 equals 1/3. 1/3 is the simplified quotient. And then finally we have 1 2/3 divided by 1/2. Let's first write this using improper fractions. So again, we have 1 2/3 divided by 1/2. As an improper fraction, 1 2/3 has a denominator of 3. The numerator is 3 times 1 plus 2, which is 5. So 1 2/3 is equal to 5/3. Then we have divided by 1/2. 1/2 as an improper fraction has a denominator of 2, and the numerator is 2 times 1 plus 1, which is 3. So the given quotient is the same as 5/3 divided by 3/2. Dividing by 3/2 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. The reciprocal of 3/2 is 2/3, and therefore this quotient is equivalent to 5/3 times 2/3. So going back to our table, the equivalent multiplication problem is 5/3 times 2/3. Multiplying, we get 10/9, which does not simplify. Because this product is equal to 10/9, so is the original quotient. 1 2/3 divided by 1/2 is equal to 10/9. So the simplified quotient is 10/9. Let's also write the quotient as a mixed number. To do this, we divide 10 by 9. So we have 10 divided by 9. There's 1, 9, and 10. We subtract, the difference is 1, and therefore the quotient is 1 1/9. So 10/9 is equal to 1 1/9. We can also express the quotient as a mixed number. If you compare these quotients to the quotients we found using a common denominator as well as our models, we will see the quotients are the same. I hope you found this helpful.